Hey subscribers and watchers, what's up? It's me, Vibs here, SlideNerd. In this video, I'm gonna talk about how to implement dependency injection with the Butterknife library. Before I start, there are two things that I would like to point out. First, if you go to Google and if you type SlideNerd dependency injection, we have a post right here that talks about all the libraries of dependency injection in detail. That includes Butterknife, RoboGuys, Android Annotations, and Dagger. The first two videos are obviously there, and the last two videos will be available on your email. If you subscribe to our email list, you will get an email that looks like this, that talks about the videos, their links, the comparison between different libraries, and a Stack Overflow that compares performance-wise which library is good, not to mention the code samples for all the libraries and all the examples that we have run here. So be sure to subscribe to our email list on SlideNerd.com. So let's take a look at what our activity looks like before adding Butterknife. This is like any other activity. You have three text views here. You use the find view by ID methods to call and initialize your text views. But with Butterknife, this is what you do. You use this annotation called @injectView, and you supply the ID of your view inside the brackets, which means you don't have to call find view by ID. Instead, you write this statement, which is butterknife.inject this. Now, this is better than writing find view by ID 10 times. Won't you agree with me? Even if you are using a fragment, the process is the same. You call @injectView, and then you say butterknife.inject inside your onCreateView or onViewCreated. Depends on you where you want to initialize stuff. If you take a look at how a list adapter can change, if you remember, earlier we had a view holder where we would take a view object in the parameter right here and then use this view object to call find view by ID. But again, that can be eliminated by saying butterknife.inject this object, take this view, and use this view to find our text views that we need inside our view holder. So this is how you can use it with a list adapter as well. And this would be the complete code roughly for your base adapter. Now, I did not get enough time to experiment Butterknife with a recycler view adapter. However, I would like to know from you in the comments, what do you think? Is it working for you? Are you experiencing any issues? Do let me know. And don't forget to subscribe to our email list at SlideNerd.com. And if you can go ahead and Google us saying SlideNerd Udemy, you'll find all our courses out there, our social accounts on SlideNerd Twitter and SlideNerd Facebook, and all the code for this video. The practical example and everything is out there on SlideNerd GitHub. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Have a nice day.